Hey, sweetheart. Oh, poor darling, you obviously needed to sleep.
It doesn't really hurt or anything. 12:30.
Yeah, well, you obviously needed the rest, didn't you?
And what about school?
Yeah, but you're ill, love. Your body needed to sleep. Oh, have you got it, Rox?
Oh, right, yeah.
Mum.
Oh, come on, this is going to help.
If you think I'm doing the over-concerned father, but just wait till you see Ryan.
He bought me grapes, Dad.
Yeah, well, it's the thought that counts. It's better than just hovering around here, isn't it?
Yeah, well, maybe he should come round more often to look after me.
Yeah, maybe he should.
You know, if the rashes get worse at night, maybe he should stay.
Well, I don't think that's entirely necessary, darling. I think Dad and I can look after you.
No, maybe he should do that too. Where are you going, love?
School.
Yeah, but, well, you can't. I mean, you're ill. You're only going to make it worse, Della.
We'll be fine. See you later.
Hey, bye. Nice uniform, though.
Our Byronic hero stalks through the novels with dark thoughts in his mind and an even darker heart concealed within. Today, we are going to read excerpts from The Fall of the House of Usher. And those of us assiduous enough to belong to the book club will be streets ahead. Commence. Della Wells, just because you look like an apparition does not mean you can come and go like one, with no explanation.
Sorry, Miss Colgren.
Della, you look so pale.
That is not a rash. That is a love scar. And you're not coming to the book club like that. What do you think people are going to think?
What they already think. It's so kids from Fay.
Right. Let's go. In your groups. Commence.
Della, Auntie Rachel read it to me last year. I might be a bit rusty, but I can still help if you want.
Sorry, Della.
No, don't be. I'd rather not sit around and discuss books any more than I need to. I want to live the life.
Did he suck the common decency out of you as well?
Save your breath, Frankie. You'll need it to blow up your boyfriend.
You can't go through life swapping one psychological disorder for another. What's wrong now?
Me. My life's falling apart again, Steph. Me, my home, my family. And I know it sounds absurd to say so, but last night I think I did something absolutely terrible.
What kind of thing?
Well, I'm too ashamed to say, but when I think about it now, I feel such shame. And yet I know I'm perfectly capable of doing it again. What do I do to stop it?
It does depend on what it is. I mean, if you're not going to go into specifics, then how can I?
Well, I would, Steph. I'm just very tired.
You know, yesterday you said you came to me as a friend. But you just want me to reel off the same old stuff again, don't you? You're a man, Duncan. You have to do what you want.
What's happened to you, Steph? Something's different about you.
As in your paranoia, Duncan. Don't worry. I mean, what is it, this thing you feel capable of? What did you ever do wrong? Are you all right?
Oh, it's the loss of blood. It's weakened your constitution.
No, it's you in my room.
Dad, what is he doing here?
Well, Dad, you said you'd feel better if Ryan stayed, so here he is.
Dad!
It's okay. Whatever it is that's doing this to you, I'll protect you.
There's nothing to protect me from.
Yeah. Well, we'll see about that, won't we? And you, get some good sleep.
I know why you're here.
You summoned me. Your father told me.
He thinks I'm safe with you.
Oh, you are. See, I even stopped the storm for you.
You've seen her, haven't you? I saw it in your eyes. You know her. Please tell me.
Jane Harper.
Please come back. Please! No.
This is no place even for a haunted soul like yours, Joshua.
I like kids.
I hardly see you now. Nobody does. What do you find to do all day?
In the day, I sleep.
And what do you do at night?
I wake up and go out to play.
Darkness is your friend, Joshua. As it is mine, too. We have both used it in our poetry. Mr. Truelove thought our play was magnificent. He's considering me as deputy because we brought so much light to the school. We did. You and I. I wrote the play in my way, did I not, Beast?
Don't call me Beast, Miss Colquitt.
Why, Joshua, then we shadows have offended.
And I didn't write the play. Josh Alexander wrote it. Not you, not me. You see, people like you, you pretend and you repress. Everyone here feels my pain. It's a release. And I've been released.
Your turn? If things had turned out differently, we would not have needed to have done it like this.
It's strange whatever, I guess.
Is it? I think it's strange that you don't have the rights to someone that you had before. Like Celeste. We should learn to make us trust each other more.
It's really brave of you to look after me all night. Making sure I'm okay.
Is there a difference now?
Close your eyes.
But you haven't finished.
If you do, I might kiss you.
She's unconscious. Please, come quick. Oh, Rachel, I was so worried. What's wrong?
Samuel's dead.
Well, I've got a shift in an hour, mate.
Do you love my wife?
Duncan.
Sad. I know you do. I want to hear you say it. Slowly and clearly. I want to hear you say it.
I love Natalie.
And you had it with her, didn't you? Come on, Dexter. I want to hear you say it.
It happened, but not now. Not now, Duncan. It's Natalie. She's doing your brain in, and mine. With mind games, she's playing games. Nothing's happening now, I swear to you.
Don't put it on her. That's my wife you're talking about. You wish I wasn't here, getting in the way, stopping you. Admit it.
You wish I were dead. Say it.
I thought it had crossed my mind. Duncan. All right. It's not worth it. My little girl will be home in a minute. She won't want to see her dad all over the world, will she? We can talk about it, mate. Come on. Come on, Duncan. Come on. Comes a black day when you get killed by your own gun. This is my gun, isn't it? From the cab. You'd have had a pistol whip me to death with this. It's a fake. The old Bill would do me right in if they found a real one in the cab, wouldn't they? Only keep it just in case. Most crims are bullies, you know. They'd run like the wind if you turned it on.
That's not all that was in your car, though, was it, Woody? Photograph of Natalie.
Natalie's pretty, Duncan, very pretty.
Natalie was right, wasn't she? I am absolutely pathetic.
No, you're not. Any idiot can pull a trigger, Duncan. A real man to put a gun down and face what comes next.
Oh, at last! You two boys made up, have you? I'll go and put a kettle on, eh? Makes all the cup of tea. Now that we're all friends.
Because that's what we are, Duncan, aren't we? Friends.
Nice to see something on an even keel again. Been a lot of weird stuff flying around here lately.
Well, you speak for yourself, Charlie boy, because that ain't nothing compared to what us cabbies see overnight.
I would hate to drive about with all those, you know, you bad people around.
Oh, well, no, actually, it's the people that make it rather fun.
Roger, having said that, it would be nice to have something better than that old banger to drive around in. I mean, the times I've been in a sticky situation,
You know, and I needed the radio working. I'll keep meaning to get it fixed, but you know what it's like. Remind me tomorrow.
Oh, Duncan, no tie tonight, eh? Must be casual day at the office.
Presentation's all Natalie, my dear. Don't you worry about that. Duncan knows the way to a punter's wallet.
Oh, if only he knew his way around elsewhere. Of course, you're an old hand, aren't you, Eddie?
No more tricks, eh, Natalie? Actually, on second thoughts, trick away, if you like tricking. You know why? Because I love you.
Where are you going, Duncan?
Well, I'm going to work. To the cab firm. Don't worry. Woody will pay you due care and attention. And you know what I've realised, Natalie? I'm rather good at this work. So despite you, I'm rather happy.
You know, he was. I could feel him before he went, but now there's nothing.
Why are you saying this?
Oh, Lucy dear, because it's true. It's past him. Moved on. We were before, we were linked, and I could feel his pain. Now I feel only a void.
No, you're lying. You want to turn me against him. It's just avoiding you. It's a lie.
Lucy, you don't have to let me in, but remember, we will get through this. I swear I wouldn't say anything that wasn't true. And I won't take the deputy job, not now. Not after this. Lucy? Fitting memorial for the dead.
Oh, I've had the smart office. Don't you worry about that. No, I like the people. The real people that I've met on this job.
No, mate. You're wasted on this kid. You got an attitude now.
Yeah, I suppose I have, actually. You know, between you and me and the four walls of this beautiful cab, I have to say, I thought I was alone. But you know I'm not. I drive people around, take them wherever they want, and then I get to go home at the end of the day. And then I get to talk to you. And you're the only one who really understands me. You're the only one I want to talk to.
No, don't stop. Don't stop. I don't want you to stop.